Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I'm the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In this tutorial, I will show you how to navigate QuickBooks Online. To log into QuickBooks Online, you need to type qbo.intuit.com in your browser. Your login screen will look like this. This is the same URL that you need to use to access QuickBooks Online from any device. I recommend bookmarking this URL in your browser so you can access it anytime from any device. This will be your main dashboard screen that you see every time you log into QuickBooks Online. In the center, you have different money graphs based on the income and the expense transactions that you have entered into QuickBooks Online. At the top right corner of the screen, you have this privacy mode that you can turn on and turn off as needed. I recommend turning it on if you are in a public space and you don't want others to see your financial data when you walk away from your computer. At the left side, you will see all of your bank and credit card accounts that you have entered inside of QuickBooks Online. You can change the order of the accounts by clicking on the pencil icon, then drag and move the accounts to the order that you want them to be displayed. Then click Save. This is your left navigation bar. I will give you a basic overview of these 11 tabs in this tutorial and cover how to use each tab in separate training videos. The second tab after your dashboard tab is known as your banking tab. Here you have your banking center, which shows all of the bank accounts and credit card accounts that you have connected to QuickBooks Online, as well as the banking feeds underneath each of those accounts. The second tab is called the Bank Rules tab. This is where any rules that you have created in QuickBooks Online to record transactions will appear in this screen. The Sales or Invoicing tab is where you will see all of your sales transactions, such as sales receipts, invoices, and payments. The All Sales tab shows you all sales transactions, and then the Invoices tab shows you all of the invoices that you have created in the system with indications as to which ones are paid and which ones are overdue. To add new customers, donors, members, grant entities, committee members for your church, you will use the customers list under the customer tab. To track what you sell and how you get your funds in your nonprofit or in your church, you will use the products and services list. The expenses tab is where you will see all of your expenses, such as bills, checks, bill credits, and credit cards in QuickBooks Online. When you add new vendors, they will be listed under the Vendors tab. The Workers tab shows you both employees and contractors that you have marked as 1099 contractors, with the option that says track payments for 1099 in their vendor profile. Projects are meant to be used to group related activities in one place. This is a new feature that was introduced in QuickBooks Online as of 2018. The Report Center is the entire reason that you're doing accounting. Now, this center houses all of the reports that you will need to run your nonprofit, as well as the reports that you will need to provide to your accountant. Here you will see your standard reports that QuickBooks has created for you and any reports that you have customized in QuickBooks Online and saved to share with others. The Taxes tab shows the sales tax forms and the payments that you track in QuickBooks Online. There will also be a separate tab in the same center. If you are using QuickBooks Online payroll services, there will be a separate tab that shows your payroll taxes and any payroll tax forms that you have processed inside of QuickBooks Online. The accounting tab shows you your charts of accounts. Here you can see a list of all of your balance sheets and your profit and loss accounts that you create in QuickBooks Online. Switching to the Reconcile tab, here is where you will go to every single month to reconcile your finances in QuickBooks Online. My Accountant tab is a place to collaborate and share documents with your accountant, with your provisor, or with your tax preparer inside of QuickBooks Online. That is all there is to the left navigation bar. Here is your top navigation bar that shows four main icons. The first icon is called the Quick Create Plus icon. Now this screen shows you four main menus that you're going to use to create and enter transactions inside of QuickBooks Online. The second icon is the Search Magnifying Glass icon. Here you can search for transactions inside of QuickBooks Online. You can see recent transactions. You can do an advanced search. You can search for an amount or a name. You can search for anything inside of QuickBooks Online using this option. This is the gear icon. It houses all of your company settings and features needed to set the core foundation of your financial reports and prepare your tax return. In a separate video, I'm going to show you how to customize the account settings in this particular screen. The final icon is the help icon. This is where you will search for questions in QuickBooks Online community forum or contact Intuit directly if you have any issues going on with your QuickBooks Online file. If you are working with a provisor or an accountant, I usually recommend reaching out to them first before you try to contact Intuit. That way you get accurate information and you get the correct answer to your questions that are very industry specific. That is a quick overview of how to navigate your QuickBooks Online company file. Watch my next video to see how to customize your account and settings in QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching.